Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure. 7 days to die. Right on. Okay, so what's going on today? Well, today I figure day 21, so we're going to place these spikes all the way around our base. And then what we're going to do is we're going to run directly to this spot here. We're going to try and find this treasure. Then, if we have enough time, maybe we'll scooch up all the way up to here to kind of loot that building here, and then run all the way back if we have time. So that's kind of the plan. I'm not sure if we'll be able to do that, but we might be able to. And then on day 22, I kind of want to build a base in this town here, because it's going to be kind of a launching pad to explore this out that way, and explore this down here, which looks like another crappy biome. And hopefully underneath, there'll be some resources underneath this biome. Because the Lushful Echo has told me that in this biome, there are no resources underneath the ground. Which means that, yeah, we need to get out of this biome and kind of venture into these biomes here. And so, yeah. So that's kind of like the plan, the overall plan. But right now, it's the day 21 horde. So we'll kind of do things up until that horde, and so yeah, so I will meet you all in the morning here, and now you know the plan. Okay, so it's not quite morning yet, but I was looking in here under the skills, and I noticed there's Health Nut, which takes 20 athletics, which increases our wellness, I think. So that would be a useful skill, maybe. What else would be a useful one? Maybe this one, quicker crafting potentially, but maybe not. Maybe the fixer, because the repair time. Yeah, I'm not sure. We get 42 points, hey? And I don't think there is anything to really spend it on. Scavenging. Fast Eddie, we can get actually this one. Fast Eddie. Bang. Perfect. Okay, so that's a level 2. Then the next one would be 30 scavenging, which would be loot quality plus 25. And then after that we'll get the last Fast Eddie, which is awesome. And I think that about covers it. There's the treasure hunter thing here. Improve your compass treasure track and get a better at finding treasure. I'm not sure how that works. I'm not sure if that's even worth it. Maybe we'll dump points into that at some point. But yeah, here we are. So yeah, I will meet you as soon as it's daytime. Okay, here we are. So it's now day 21. Woo! Let's go, go, go! Bang, bang, bang! Okay, so we're gonna place these last set of spikes here all the way around as best as we can. Hopefully we won't overheat. So how is everybody doing? Make sure you grab your drink and your tasty treats, because it might be a long episode. Might not be, I don't know. Should bring out one more, I think. And then like that. And then like this. Perfect. So yeah, so 7 days to die, man. Yeah, I'm just gonna carry on with this. Gonna place these spikes here. Gonna place them all the way around. And I shall return as soon as that is done. Okay, so we are done with all of that. So now, guess what? Now it's time to head on over down to our treasure map that we can see up in the top radar. And so I'm going to run down to that area. And I shall return once something interesting comes along our way. Okay, we are nearing the treasure chest up ahead. Should be around here somewhere. Hope it's not underneath this rock. Let's see where we are in the map. Okay, we're gonna zoom right in, because I think we need to get right about in the middle of it. Whoa, whoa, look at that. So you think about here. Do I have a shovel? Yes, we do. Let's start digging. Maybe it's underneath this rock. So it shouldn't be too far down. Should be only a few blocks underneath us. Just have to dig a little bit. Let's see, one more. Come on. Let's see how good our skills are. No, how about underneath this rock? Shall we find it, maybe? Come on. Brutal. How about here? Maybe one more down? Let's see. Man. How about one more down? We'll go one more down. I think it's about three down, maybe? Let's go this way. I have a feeling it's underneath the rock here. Come on. I don't want this to collapse on me, actually. Oh, shoot! Hello, hello! Hello! Ooh! Missed. Sneaky, sneaky lady! There we go. Nice. Okay. I would like to think it's actually on this side instead. No, it's probably underneath the rock here. Because if you look at where the arrow is, it's actually higher chance of it being around here. Because my arrow is about in the middle. So let's dig. Let's dig this out over here like this. Okay, so that way it's easier to get down. I don't see no zombies. That's like this. Maybe one more down. Has to be around here somewhere. Looks like the rock layer. Well, we'll go this way. Eventually this will collapse. Maybe because we'll dig enough underneath it. I'll find you. Oh, man. Map. Yeah, it has to be around here somewhere. Let's see here. I'm not sure how deep. Unless it's deeper, but that'd be kind of weird. I'm figuring you'll find like a box underneath. Come on. I'll keep digging, and I tell you what. I will come back as soon as something interesting is found. Okay, folks. I was digging all around here, and look. Here it is. Treasure chest. Untouched. Woo! Look at that. Sweet. So I was digging in the wrong place all along. Okay. So that is complete. So now we need to find some water, which would be basically directly watering hole. So what? Directly the way we came. So we'll just go this way. We're going to stop at the watering hole and fill up with some water. So we got MacDiver's book, which, oh, we already know this stuff. Metal armor, scrap metal armor. Okay, so that means scrap metal armor. It's gonna kind of take a quick peek. Okay, so we already have that stuff. Okay, so I guess we can scrap the book. This one we don't have. We can read that one. Ooh, herbal antibiotics. Read this ancient. Nice. Nice. And this is interesting. Nail some chicks challenge. Interesting. Rocket launcher barrel. Okay, cool. So that turned out to be quite actually pretty good. Crazy. Herbal antibiotics. Nice. We have that. Oh, there's that. Is that what I think it is? Where? Come on. Nice. Let's start chopping this bad boy up. We're going up a level. Nice, nice, nice. Oh man, oh man, oh man. Day 21's a good day. Time to drop off stuff, of course. Okay. Let's run, run, run. Let's see here. Watering hole. So further up this way a little bit. Let's throw this in here. Let's make sure we've got a couple sets of glass jars. Man, I'm excited, folks. You know, day 21 horde's gonna be exciting, I think. Gonna have lots of fun with that. And then day 22, we're gonna kind of look at our alternate base that we're gonna set up, which is nice. So we're gonna have to bring those trees over, Hello, hello, Chicky. Had to bring those trees over and plant them because we're gonna need that. I think there's already a tree there, so we should be able to get a good start with building up spike defenses around one of the buildings and going from there. I think we're gonna go on the two-story building, I think. Let's see here, where's the water deposit? Okay, sweet. Just have to essentially follow this road and it'll take us right to the deposit. Man, oh man, folks. So we're gonna fill this up with water. Did I loot this? Yeah, empty duffel bag. We're leaving that because if we come back around day 31, or I'm not sure when exactly, but whenever I looted that, whenever we come back, we will be able to loot that again. Okay, let's throw those in there. Fill up these. Perfect. Throw those up there. Excellent. Okay. Now I'm going to run back all the way to the base and to unload, and I will be back. Okay, perfect. So, now we're going to give it a shot. I'm going to try and run in... Yeah, I'm going to try and run all the way up to here. Go quick waypoint. I'm going to try and give it a shot and see what happens. And so I will meet you when I get up there. Okay, here's the ridge above the... above the town. Kind of scaling down it. We don't want to break a leg. There we go. Okay. So we're here at that town. We got zombies all around us. We're going to run into that place. We're just going to hit it hard into the working... Is it the stiffs? Yeah. Basically just run into this place hardcore. Okay. We're just going to just loot this stuff like there's no tomorrow. Cash register. We got that. Empty back here, I think. Empty. Untouched. Good. Oh, we got those. Do we have time? Let's do it anyways. Shouldn't take too long. Just a few hits. Let's do it crouched. So we know zombies come by. Come on. Okay, let's see what's inside this bad boy. Ooh, spike club schematic, which we already know. Shotgun short stock. I think we already have this one. So we're just going to dump it. Okay, and that's it. We're going to run all the way back. So this is what I wanted to do. Just quickly grab everything out of here. And yeah, now time to head all the way back. So, of course, to spare you the boringness, I will meet you back at the base. Okay, here we are. We are back at the base. I think that's it. I think I'm just going to call it right here. Let's see. Might have been a short episode. I don't know. I wasn't keeping track. So that was a good haul. So let's move the garden hoe into here. Is there any more? Iron shovel. We need to make a toolbox. These sledgehammers we can just smelt down. We can keep this one. But the reality is we'll just probably smelt them all down anyways. The anvil we can just smelt down as well. And then we have the iron shovels, which we can just smelt down too, because we have the steel shovel, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, and then we got casino tokens. Cool beans. Man, that was awesome. That was a good haul. And we're coming up to the day 21 horde, which obviously we will have to do in our next episode. So, yeah, so thank you everybody for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this episode as always, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next one. Bye bye.
I think that's good.
Yeah, I think we'll be okay now
until the evening then.
Yeah. Grab all my goods that I just got.
It looks like every 4 hours, maybe. If there's any kind of rhyme or reason there.
Ain't no rhyme, no reason.
I'm also gonna make use of those letters we can make in here too. Just because.
There is a dog here.
Yeah, but he's not bothering anybody.
Use that. It's a waste.
Okay, so what's harvestable here?
Not bothering anybody, he's bothering me.
Is he? Oh, in the pit? He fell in the pit?
I don't know no, not that way. It's where it was before, but he's getting stuck on the, buildings and stuff.
Yeah. They seem to be kind of dumb that way. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're, aimed at a certain person, so that,
Now it's like it lost me, right?
Yeah.
I had a dog chasing me, and then, mid-chase, he decided to run away. I don't even know what happened.
It's fine to go after these things.
If you dig up dirt that has grass on top of it, you don't actually get the grass. You have to dig the grass first.
Really?
Oh. Right. Yeah. I might just leave one row of dirt blank just for grass to grow grass on.
Yeah, you could. Because if we need grass, right, then...
I thought someone was at the door. Real life. But they were not. No one was there. All right.
Or if they were, you took too long and they're gone.
I didn't invite them. They're not welcome. Hermit, damn it, for a reason.
What are you doing here?
Yeah, kind of. I don't know.
A used car lot. Never seen this before.
Yeah, it's all new stuff, new random gen stuff.
Oh, really? Yeah, see? You have a wrench? Actually, you can take those cars apart for the engine.
It's a car repair shop.
Oh.
There's probably cars there, right?
Yeah.
Is there an engine in there? Yeah. Yeah. Cool.
Well, do you have a wrench?
You guys can run over here, though. There's lots of stuff and things.
Oh, after the horde, we will.
Don't worry. That's where we're going.
That's going to be a priority after the horde.
Yeah. When is the horde going to be? This afternoon?
No, day 14.
Oh, that horde.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, it's today. Yeah. It's going to happen in...
a couple hours?
Yeah. It's the special midday horde.
Wink, wink.
Oh, I found a piece of paper out here.
Well, Jason knows about it. He got one of those.
I have a broken leg.
That is weird how you got your horde early like that, but it's funny.
That was weird.
It is really weird.
But then other ones, and they were just coming out screamers.
Yeah.
Well,
they were.
I don't know. I have more footage to submit, and you guys can make your own decisions.
So far, it looks like screamer behavior, right? So.
Well, except
well, they have to see you. I haven't been spotted by them all. You know what I mean? They just keep coming regardless.
I don't know. I've heard they were going to change it so they don't. As long as they just see, any evidence of you, they'll call horde, so they don't need to see you anymore, and that might have put that
all they
in.
Have to do is just see that you have a house, and they'll call a horde.
Yeah, see spikes, or they see any kind of building.
Well, obviously.
That'll definitely do it. Unfortunately, it's just endless.
Yeah.
Found a blood draw kit.
But then there is a bug, too, where some people have those endless hordes, right? It is a day 7 horde that's endless.
I told you, I don't know if Sharlenwar told you, but day 9, the sun never came up.
Yeah, I don't know what to say to that.
Pitch black.
Yeah,
I don't know what to say to that. Either.
It was weird. You can sort of see where... Yeah. Well, you know how you can see the light coming through the trees?
Yeah.
You can see where the sun was supposed to be by doing that technique, but it was just nothing. So yeah, that's coming up. That's day 9. I gotta edit that footage. And
just so you know, the red moon is blood moon
the
hordes. Yeah.
Okay. Is it usual to have them multiple nights in a row? Red moons?
No.
Okay.
That means you're stuck on horde night. Yeah,
it's exciting. It'll be an exciting single player adventure then, isn't it, huh?
I think so, yeah, and it's gonna be very challenging too.
Yeah, well,
I'm just saying it'll be very challenging.
Well, I know. I like to learn under a challenging environment.
So it'll be fun.
Good stuff that way.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't let it dishearten you. So. Don't let it. Just go through it. And... you need to see the footage. Both that's for sure.
14.6.
Yeah.
I enjoy a good challenge. I play Minecraft in the hardcore mode for fun.
Like the kind where it deletes the.
Yeah,
so
we haven't
as well.
Seen that in a while.
My Minecraft series—that's what it is. My single-player Minecraft series is all hardcore.
Yep.
Yeah, so there you go, folks.
I died once so far, though.
You go over to Jace Machine Gaming.
You watch any of his videos, Sharlenwar?
Yeah.
What Minecraft? No.
Not everyone watches every video of everyone's.
There's
channel,
only one
like,
guy I
watch
for Minecraft
now,
unfortunately.
I'm even going back and watching Evil Dropper's old videos for some reason.
I don't have very many videos.
Yes.
Yeah. So I like to binge watch, right? So I like to wait and then watch like 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 of the same series, you know, in succession.
I like
so.
To keep things moving. I like to have a lot of different content going. How many channels do you guys subscribe to?
Just a handful, like really just you guys for the most part, and then maybe a couple.
Yeah.
Big okay. ones I do.
Evil, how many channels do you follow?
Oh, a lot.
Like how much is a lot to you?
Like, I watch YouTube all day and still have way too many videos to watch.
Wow.
I'm subscribed to 400 channels myself.
Yeah,
oh
I'm,
my
I'm
god.
Subscribed
what the
to
heck?
Hundreds. I pinpoint like. I think I'm at like 250 or so.
That's all I watch. Like, in between my content, I watch YouTube. I don't watch cable. I don't watch TV.
Yeah, I don't watch cable television either. I haven't had cable since I was a teenager.
I have a vast range of interests, so YouTube fills that hole, like, you know, like science channels and history channels, and so it's awesome. There's constantly something new and different popping up in my feed that keeps me occupied.
See, that tree was 500 that I just chopped, and it was looked the same as the one that was 250.
Okay.
I don't watch every video that every channel puts out. Like
it's
this.
Impossible.
Like, well, you know, I might just not be interested in that particular game. You know,
that's
yeah,
true.
Exactly.
The guy Meaty, I watch him for his 7 days content. He also has a Minecraft show, and I think maybe other shows. I don't follow those though. I just follow his 7 days.
See, it's like another guy I watch. Right, like I watch Cage, but I like to follow his like Subnautica. Or like kind of like some of the other games I don't have necessarily. So
yeah.
Like I really like this.
How it was for Minecraft. I didn't have it and I was fascinated by it. So I just started watching a lot of videos initially, and that got me into actually wanting the game at that point. So but yeah, I used to just watch. I liked it because of the retro style graphics, and then when I saw people building stuff, I was like, oh, that's cool.
Yeah, no, it is cool. It's still cool to this day. I like it. It kind of pioneered a lot of the open world stuff, I think.
Yeah. It definitely changed the way that developers think about making their games, for good or for bad. The first time I saw 7 Days to Die was in a generic B video. He was, like, it had just come out, or one of the early alphas was out, and he didn't know what the hell he was doing. And he climbed up onto, like, a factory and tried to put a sleeping bag down, which he then fell through the floor into the darkness
here.
Of the factory.
Oh, shit.
Dogs? Okay.
I'm not gonna cry wolf, but I know they're stuck on, like, the buildings and stuff here.
Yeah, that's from before.
So that basically leaves a certain area unexplorable. There's one following me,
I
think.
Right on your ass. Well, the hatch is open.
No, you can keep up with them. You better get up.
It doesn't matter. People don't. You clip through people. So.
Do you? No, I think you.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah, look. Oh. On the ladder, I know you do. I guess not. In here. So where's his
is
dog?
He, also,
he's
guys,
dead now.
I've had no problem getting up the ladder recently. I'm doing
because
nothing
right on,
different.
But you should have a problem.
Should be here now. Should be dead.
I broke out the block underneath it and everything, so it should be fine.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I haven't had any problems, but I, you know, it looks the same as it was before when I do have. It's like very weird ladders in me, very 50-50. I don't change the way I go up them any differently. They just either work really good immediately, or I just get caught at the bottom.
That's interesting.
But my shoelace gets caught on the bottom rung, and I can't quite get up. Yeah, it's like, damn it. you know, and you're trying to get up, something's gonna kill you. It's terrifying. It's terrifying. So they were describing it during the Twitch chat, during TwitchCon. They were saying that they wanted the game to have, they were describing it sort of sounding like Skyrim a little bit. Skyrim in space with like faction quests and quest trees and stuff that you can set up on your own, like you could set up your own quests and things. So it would be, you know, influenced by that style of game that's popular in other things too, but...
Yeah, but will it be like a simulation where I can build stations? I'm holding on to it. I was going to cook it.
I need to eat, so can you please cook it?
Yeah, certainly.
Build a simulation where you can build stations, what?
Yeah, no, exactly, like simulations, and because like building a lot of that stuff, it's useless if you can't put NPCs into it.
Well, they're making it so that you're going to have NPCs. You're going to have NPCs working on your ships.
Nice, and that's what I want.
In the game. And you're going to have to feed them and keep them happy. Otherwise, they will mutiny on you and take your ships.
Nice.
Yeah, that's what they're planning on doing. So there's some crazy stuff they got in the works.
That's exciting, then.
Yeah. And there's going to be randomly generated stuff mixed with the pre-created stuff. So there's like something like 30... different mobs that they have planned, plus a series of mobs that will be spawned with random attributes, and those are the ones that I'm kind of excited to see. Those will be the truly unique creatures, and I want to be able to tame them.
Okay. Here, I'm gonna put the meat in the box down here.
Did win the food box.
Yeah, I will. Just in case someone else wanted to grab from it.
And cook it up.
Hit up an animal somewhere. Pick this up.
I was thinking about hitting up an animal earlier, but I didn't see any.
Yeah, so if StarMade turns into like a simulation thing, then that would be amazing, right? Because then there's a point to building your stations, a point to building your cruise quarters, and all that kind of fun stuff, right?
So, yeah, basically they're setting up so that you can set up and designate certain areas of your ship to be workstations. So you'll have engineering and your quarters and all that stuff. And, that's freaking amazing. I'm really excited about that. There's 7 charred meat in here that I'm about to get out and leave. I'm just taking my boiled meat that I'm cooking up. My boiled meat.
The fleet mechanics is pretty good as well. It's, of course, it needs
so
work,
far,
right?
Yeah,
but
it definitely needs work, but it's got enough in place that it's super fun to play with.
Yeah, I haven't tried it yet.
Oh, Michael McDougald. Good old Michael McDougald said we were all fags. Thank you, Michael McDougald.
Yay!
Apparently. Wow. God bless his little heart. Poor
little
fella.
That's funny.
Yeah, it is funny.
The digital keyboard, you people.
Like, I'm going to insult these people.
That's
so
not insulting. It's just, it's funny. It's a joke more than anything.
I know it's not insulting. But it is funny because it's like, oh, they're going to get mad. No. Not much gets me mad.
Yeah, exactly.
It's the internet. I've been on YouTube for 10 years, so...
I've been using the internet since the 90s, so...
Oh, that internet. Remember Prodigy? And America Online?
Yeah, CompuServe or whatever. Yeah, there's a bunch of them.
Okay. Where's the raw meat? I can make meat stew, actually.
In the food box. Meat
in the box behind you.
I put it in the food box, like he said.
Yeah. Like he said.
Only 5? Oh,
that's,
shit, you guys are eating like pigs, wow.
So I said we gotta go get more meat.
We had like over 20 in there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow. We had to make some food there.
We had to eat it.
I used my points on
the... It was the first time I had to eat all
the
day.
Survivor, so that I wouldn't eat food as much.
Nice.
That seems like your guys' biggest concern right now, so...
Well, it wasn't until recently.
Well, yeah, but it's always like killing animals makes you smell, and then it attracts zombies, and it's like never ending.
It doesn't attract zombies that bad.
Right, that's
local
good.
Zombies.
it's not really anything to be worried about.
If you're walking around, they'll notice you, but it doesn't, like, bring them to you in any sort of massive way.
But just if you're close enough to them, basically, right? Like, then they would. But, you know, that would be, like, if you're inside a building with holding meat, and then, you know, they're just outside, then they'll kind of come towards you, right? So, I don't know. It's never really been a real problem, I find.
Yeah, meat stew is definitely way better than vegetable stew. Plus 7 fullness, plus 0.1 wellness on vegetable. Oh, yeah. And plus 20 fullness, plus 1.6 fullness on meat.
Oh yeah, the meat stew is the way to go. Okay.
Yeah, I like this new workbench.
Yeah. It's good if you want to make massive quantities. You don't get the experience
I guess
for
that makes sense.
Yeah, it doesn't tie up your queue.
You can ABC all the time.
I see that multi-grid.
There was in the medical box.
Oh yeah. Always convert that to, there's no reason not to. Antibiotics.
I'll just convert it down into whatever.
To antibiotics, yeah.
Basics,
oh man.
Toss in here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 more blocks need to be done and the walls all scrap ironed up. I collected a little bit of scrap iron while I was out there. Messing with the dog. But I'll try and find an engine tomorrow. Let's... Oh, there's the dog horde.
Oh, man.
Hi, fighters.
Oh, there, it's more. Hello, hello! Come in!
Hello!
Get impaled on the spikes.
Where you want the paper? Oh, I see. There you want the paper. I see.
In the explosive box, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna use that to make ammo.
Oh, what? I'm level 21 now for some reason.
Oh, yeah. Did you ever put those shotgun pieces? Jason, did you say you had, like, shotgun parts? And...
If I did, I'd put them up there. Whatever I find, I put them up in the
gun
box.
Them. I don't see shotgun parts up here.
Errol? Maybe I don't know if I had parts necessarily.
And you said you had a stock and parts.
They might be at my other place. I might have left them.
Okay.
Not to say, so I'll just get them in them. Perhaps in the morning.
Well, there's two BD full days, bottoms, basically.
What's the PDU? Is that like a military thing?
Yeah, battle dress uniform.
Weird. Oh,
okay.
Military plus, pants, basically.
Plus 5.
And they might just look different, that's all.
Yeah. There's...
Oh, look at that. I see something way out in the distance. Oh, it looks like a bee? Why would there be a bee?
There's endless hordes.
No.
Oh, yeah. If you ever lose glue, just convert it to duct tape right away.
Okay.
That's the only use it has.
You can turn it into duct tape right away?
Yeah. With glue and cloth, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah,
and that way it frees up a slot, and that's only someone's got is stuck to you.
I had to move my bed because someone used the bathroom and it stinks really bad. I don't know who was there last, but it smelled like something died in your lower intestine. All's quiet.
I was just looking at the map, seeing where I want to go tomorrow.
Trying to deal with this inventory mess you guys left me.
Cool.
Inventory mass? It's not inventory mass, it's all organized.
Yeah,
it's pretty organized.
Very organized.
I'm just gonna put this randomly in this chest, just because you said that.
What's that?
It belongs in that chest, just not in that particular spot in that chest.
That's fine.
You guys take
those
diamonds.
You guys remove the chairs that were outside just now?
I didn't.
Maybe.
Okay. Because I was sitting in a chair and I turned around and it was gone. And the other chair was gone also. And I was like, is this a bug? Is this a glitch?
You know the adage, if it ain't nailed down, take it. And if it is...
It's fuel. It's fuel for the forge and stuff, right?
Right.
This is the apocalypse, man. We've got to burn everything.
Burn everything, man.
It's like your old tools. Like, once you're done with them, you just put them in the forge to reforge them back into metal, right? Or you can fix them, too. But if they're too low to fix, then you can...
Yeah, it's better to just put them back in the reforge.
Yeah, and then craft a new one, right? Because I think you get the same amount of metal back, almost.
Interesting.
You get the exact same amount back.
There you
Not
go.
Almost. You do.
I wasn't sure if it was the exact same amount, so.
It is.
A couple of water holes. I didn't see that other one until.
And vitamins, you might as well just use, unless you plan on drinking out of unsanitary water supplies. Is it, okay. That's good for just straight wellness, right?
I wasn't sure.
Yeah, no, it's up to you.
I could use wellness, I died twice.
Yeah, you probably want to eat the meat stew then, too. That could get you really good wellness.